This is TV and movie star Alejandro Rey and his wife, Joyce. This is the father of a new generation of mystery stories, Mickey Spillane, and his wife, actress Sherry Spillane. This is funny man Morty Gunty and his wife, Marilyn. This is Jack Parr's favorite funny man, Jack Douglas, and his wife, Reiko. These four celebrity couples are here to play He Said, She Said. And now, here he is. Here comes your host, Joe Garagiola. Hey, yeah. Joe.
Always think I'm going to trip on the last
Safe.
Step. But I didn't trip. Good. You're all ready. Alejandro, you almost look like you're...
I'm listening to your brother clapping at you.
My brother?
Applauding. Yeah, yeah. I imagine that he's
president of my
part
of
your
club.
Family. Yeah.
No, it's president of my family.
Oh,
club.
I see.
Yeah, there's three or four of them back there. Good. Jack, you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay, the next half hour, we're going to see if your wives can recognize you by the stories you tell us about your married lives, okay? And your wives are backstage. They can't hear us. They can only hear us when we want them to like this. Ladies, would you please press your buttons? There, Sherry. Good. How you doing back there?
Fine.
Just great.
Oh, come on. All week you give me fine.
Fantastic.
How you doing? How you doing back there?
Oh, sensational.
Ah, good. Okay. Now, when you do that, we see you on the screen, and from now on, anytime you want to talk, please press your button, okay? Each of you is playing for a different married couple in our studio audience. Winner will get a week's stay at a Holiday Inn. I'm going to cut you off now. I'll talk to you a little bit later. Bye.
Bye, Joe.
Bye. Good. Boy, they're all choked up, aren't they, huh? Okay, athletes. Gonna give you a topic. I want you to come up with an association so personal, when your wife hears it, knows it was you. Clues, one or two words. First topic. Something you never thought she'd do, but she did it. Look at Morty Gunty right now. Go ahead, Morty.
Yes. My wife... became very athletic and sports-minded in the last 3 or 4 months and started to take tennis lessons. And she's become quite good at it. And really, for her, it's terrific because she really is top klutz of all time. I mean, you know, until this point, she has never done anything athletically inclined, you know, strictly indoor sports. And really, and she's really very, very good at tennis.
So what's your clue?
I guess play tennis.
Play tennis. Okay, we've got you. It's something you never thought she'd do, but she did it, Mickey.
Now, my wife's a very lovely little actress who doesn't put on a big display out in public. And she's quite modest about things. But one day she gets in the darndest fight with a feather merchant, of all people, and wins.
A feather merchant?
A feather merchant. We've thought of fighting with a feather merchant. And she put on the doggonest battle and won.
Listen, I'm almost afraid to ask you this.
Well, no, I'm talking about a man who sells feathers. She went down to get something for a gown of hers. And here's a nice little old feather merchant who just wouldn't go along with what she wanted. And, boy, she tore up the feathers, that's all.
She tore up the feathers?
Yeah, a feather merchant.
Didn't surprise you, huh?
Oh, did she fight?
Okay, so your clues would be?
Feather merchant.
Feather merchant, all right. We've got your response. Alejandro, something that Joyce did that's really surprising.
Well, I'm afraid that with the clue I'm going to give, all four wives are going to answer. Because it's cleaning house.
Cleaning house?
Yes, sir. Because she warned me when I proposed to her, or when she proposed to me, but we don't go into that, right?
Yeah, right.
She said that she doesn't like to clean the house. She doesn't like to do anything, you know, around the house, uh-huh. And I should know about it. And I said, okay, thinking I was going to change her, right?
Uh-huh.
Well, lately she's changing, and we just moved to a new house, and she did a terrific job cleaning it. So, cleaning house. It really surprised me.
She's not available on Thursdays, is she?
No, I'm sorry. Only Sundays afternoons.
Oh, okay. Our girl just left. I thought, you know. All right, Jack, you don't have anything, huh? Something that Reiko did that you never thought she'd do?
Spoke English.
Yeah. And she never will. Oh, we had a second baby. I never thought she'd do that.
You never thought she'd do
all
that?
All of a sudden, she's pregnant and she has a baby.
All by herself.
Not in the same day, yeah.
Okay, let's go backstage and see what happens. Hello there, backstage.
Hi, Joe.
Remember to press your button now as soon as you recognize your husband. We said something you never thought she'd do, but she did it. And he said, cleaning house. Oh, we got a couple of ladies on our screen. Let's see who was first. Joyce Ray.
Well, that's got to be Alejandro, because when he proposed to me, my answer was, I don't like to clean house. And ever since then, I've stood by that rule. I don't like to clean house. But, you know, it makes him happy when I do, so I try.
That's what he told us, and we're going to give you 25 points. We said something you never thought she'd do, but she did it. And he said, play tennis. Marilyn Gunty.
There's a possibility that that's me, because I have never done anything athletic in my entire life. And suddenly, in my old age, I've taken an interest in tennis. In fact, both of us have, and we're playing now.
That's what he said. We're going to give you 25 points. You got it right on the head. We said something you never thought she'd do, but she did it. And he said, feather merchant. Sherry Spillane.
I had a fight with the feather merchant. he made them the wrong color, and he wouldn't give me my money back, and I stood there and screamed, and he wouldn't give me my money back, and he wouldn't change the color. So I just decided I was going to stay there until he either gave me my money back or changed the color, and I stayed there for half an hour screaming at the top of my lungs, and he lost all his customers, and he finally gave me my money back.
And we almost got arrested.
Good. Okay, we're going to give you 25 points for that. All right, more of He Said, She Said in just a moment. Right now, this message.
You want me to go?
Buzz till dawn. When you're up again, one too many times.
Could we do it here on the stage?
Wait a minute.
Only on Buzzer.
You're watching Love is on the Air on Buzzer.
All right, new topic now. Don't look so mean, Alejandro.
I'm ready.
I know you are. A time she had one too many. A time she had one too many. Mickey Spillane. All four of them got answers. Okay.
My wife doesn't drink, and she doesn't smoke. But one day, she got so mad at not having gotten a show that she had two doubles that I made her. And in one afternoon, she started to drink, got drunk, got sick, and got hungover. And I think it was the last time it ever happened to her.
So what would be your clue?
Drunk.
How can you say sick, drunk, sick, and hungover in one day and put it in two words?
I can't.
Now you got me.
Bad hangover? No.
No. She had a bad one, but it was too fast for anything. But she got sick.
Can you tie it into not getting the part in the show? No part? No show?
Let's see how we're going to do this. Because, as I say, she doesn't normally drink, but she better remember this one, because the only time she got wrapped up like that.
Only time. Come on, let's help him out.
That should open up a new field.
Only time. Only time?
If she can remember, she better be the only time.
Okay. It better be. All right, we've got your response. A time she had one too many, Jack Douglas. I can't wait to hear this one.
Oh, well, Reiko doesn't drink either. Isn't it funny, all the drunks, they don't drink. But anyway, never touch a drop. No, she took borrowed a car in Los Angeles, which is in Los Angeles, too, before we were married, and she had a couple of drinks, and she smashed up the car. That was it. Nothing happened to anybody.
So what would be your clue?
Drunk smash-up.
Drunk?
Well...
Drunk smasher?
That doesn't sound so good, does it?
No, you said it. I didn't.
I know. bashed car.
Bashed car. All right, we've got it. Bashed car. All right, Marty Gunty, a time she had one too many.
Yeah, our wedding day, wedding night. Yes, that was it. The day that we were married, she started to drink. You know, as people, hello, congratulations, have a drink with us, and zip, and so on and so forth. And it was a wonderful honeymoon night. It was terrific. It was a night to remember. It was sensational. You have no idea what a marvelous honeymoon night that was. This was married life. So, drunken broad that I married.
So your clue is Wedding night.
And I'm yelling, you'll cry tomorrow, and that's it. And she did. No, I did. But anyhow.
Okay, we've got the three responses. Alejandro, you didn't get a chance to play, but you had your hand up.
Well, but I'm not getting any points, so I don't know why I'm going to tell the story.
My
wife, when she has a glass of wine or two, she gets very kissing and very affectionate. With me. So that's it.
So, all right, we've got the three responses. Let's go backstage and see what happens. Hello, ladies, y'all set to play?
Mm-hmm.
All right, now press your button on, you recognize your husband. We set a time she had one too many, meaning you, obviously. A time she had one too many, and he said only time. Only time. Did she make it? Yes, she did. Marilyn Gunty.
What?
I don't know. I'll just figured I'd take a chance. There was one time that I drank too much and got a little sick, and I don't drink anymore since then, and it wasn't me.
Wasn't you?
Right.
No, that's right. It wasn't Marty. I'll have to take 10 points from you. And Sherry Spillane, we thought you would get that one.
I thought you'd never forget it. The one time she missed her part in the show, and she got drunk, sick, and hungover in one afternoon down in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina.
I don't remember. Oh, I do remember.
She was so drunk she forgot.
Well, you tell everything, don't you?
Shame on you.
Gosh.
Well, I'll have to take 10 points from you, Sherry, for not remembering that. We set a time she had one too many. He said, wedding night. Wedding night. We've got a couple of
what
ladies on our
screen.
Let's see who was first. Marilyn Gunty.
I'm beginning to feel very silly about all of this. But I did drink too much on my wedding night, and I got sick. And I guess it happens to a lot of brides, but I was one of them.
That's
Am I wrong again?
No, you're right. We're going to give you the 25 points. Right. That's what he told us. Good. Joyce. We're just kind of curious, Joyce. Why'd you press the button? Alejandro was really surprised you pressed the button.
Well, I didn't get sick or anything, but...
We were a little silly.
We were. We had such a fun wedding night. We were married in the afternoon, and we flew directly to San Francisco, and we spent the night of our wedding, just the two of us, on Fisherman's Wharf. And we were laughing and giggling, running up and down the wharf, and we just had a ball, and we had a little to drink.
We have a thing in common with a chef in that restaurant. Neither one of us knew how to cook. Yeah. It was a terrible food.
It was terrible.
Well, we were just curious, Joyce, when you pressed that button to look on your husband's face, we had to find out.
I wasn't absolutely smashed.
But
well,
close.
Kind of. Not
okay.
Remember, baby.
We said a time she had one too many, he said bashed car. Bashed car. A time she had one too many, he said bashed car. Joyce Ray.
Uh-oh.
I married an alcoholic, and I didn't know it.
No, I don't drink that much. I guess this wasn't me, but I recently smashed my car. I wasn't drinking or anything, but I thought it might be me because I did smash my car. I did smash it.
But you didn't
But
drink,
I wasn't
baby.
Drinking, no.
We didn't believe about you, drinking. Joyce.
I just had a terrible accident. The lady was limping out of the car, pretending that she'd been ruined for life with this terrible back injury. And it was terrible, but there was no alcohol involved.
You know what?
No, baby.
It wasn't Alejandro who said that. I have to take 10 points from you. Reiko.
Yeah?
We thought you would get that.
Why? I don't drink. Well, I never get drunk. I never drink.
You bashed a car.
What car? What car?
In Beverly Hills. Don't you remember hitting the school bus?
Oh, that one. No. No, I thought about that one, but I didn't drink it. That time, first time I drove.
School bus guy was driving.
Yeah, I never had a license. I just...
It was loaded. One of the kids was driving, I remember. Bus driver sitting in the back.
Oh, yeah.
A pregnant high school girl who was murdered.
Reiko, we have to take 10 points from you, Reiko.
Good.
Good, she said. Okay, ladies, we've reached the halfway point in our game. Time for you to change places with your husbands. Would you come out on stage?
Promotional consideration furnished by National Airlines with new nonstop service Miami to London. The National says you're going to have a great flight.
Now let's meet the wives.
And here they are. Here's Rako, and the Douglases have 90 points. Next is Marilyn Gunty. The Gunties have 140 points. Here's Sherry Spillane. The Spillanes have 115 points. And Joyce Ray, the Rays have 115 points, Joe.
Okay, John, we're going to see how good the husbands are recognizing their wives in just a moment, but right now, this message. On stage we have with us, here's Rako. The Douglases have 90 points. This is Marilyn Gunty. Gunties have 140 points. This is Sherry Spillane. The Spillanes have 115 points. Here is Joyce Ray. The Rays have 115 points. Now, okay. Now, your husbands are backstage. Remember, you're each playing for a different couple from our studio audience, the winner's prize, a week's stay at a Holiday Inn. Topic I have for you is his favorite fattening food. His favorite fattening food. Okay, Sherry?
Pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
He can eat 5 pumpkin pies, one right after the other. Like? And not stop. And he doesn't need Thanksgiving as an excuse.
Just any time.
Yeah, and he likes to make them himself, too. He's a very good cook.
Oh, he makes them?
Yeah, I don't cook. Are you kidding? I wouldn't cook. Well, I don't want to spoil a good thing.
You don't want to spoil a good thing?
Mickey does all the cooking.
So that's great. It's a great way to be. Okay, uh-huh. Pumpkin pie. We've got your response of his favorite fattening food. Marilyn.
Blackout cake. Yes, it's a specially prepared cake from a bakery in our neighborhood, and they're famous for it, and we're famous for buying about 4 a week.
What is it?
Because he loves it. Oh, it's very fudgy and gooey and delicious, and I hate him because I can't eat it, but he does love it.
Blackout cake.
Yes.
Okay, we've got your response. Who was next? Joyce Ray, his favorite fattening food.
Well, the problem with Alejandro is that he doesn't really like any fattening foods. That's why he stays so skinny. It's really maddening, but I guess I would say English toffee, ice cream, but that's more than two words. Toffee, ice cream,
toffee,
is that all right?
Cream.
Toffee,
okay.
Ice cream.
Okay, we've got the three
responses. And I have to make a special trip to the special ice cream store that has that special brand to get it for him.
Right after you clean the house.
Right after I... What a harried housewife I am.
Okay, we've got the three responses. Rako, do you want to say anything? What does Jack like to eat that's fattening?
Spaghetti.
Spaghetti's no calories in spaghetti.
That's make you fat.
No!
How come Italian people fat?
It's because of the garlic. They use garlic as fattening.
Garlic no make fat.
Yeah, garlic.
Well, Korean people use a lot of garlic in the food. They're not fat.
Who?
Korean people.
Oh, Korean people.
Yeah, but they're skinny. Why?
Well, maybe it is the spaghetti. I'm going to have to watch that. Yeah. Because I use garlic. I don't lose pounds, but I lose friends.
What if you...
Okay, let's go backstage and see what happens. Hello, fellas. Y'all set back there?
Yeah.
All right, okay. Press your button now and you recognize your wife, okay? We said his favorite fattening food, and she said pumpkin pie. Mickey Spillane.
Oh, man, you're talking about the thing I love most in life.
The only thing?
Pumpkin pie to me is one of the delicacies of the world. And every time I come back from Newburgh down south, I always bring myself some pumpkin. So this year I bring my wife a pumpkin for Halloween, and I put a nice little face on it. And I was all set to make a pumpkin pie of a real pumpkin, and a silly slab went and threw it out in the garbage just because Halloween was over. Could have killed her.
That's what you tell us, Mick. We're going to give you 25 points. We said his favorite fattening food. She said toffee ice cream. Alejandro Ray.
Well, I eat ice cream by the pounds, and I don't know, that's all. And I love ice cream, and she buys pounds and pounds, and I eat them all.
That's
but
enough.
I never get fat.
Yeah, that's what gets us all upset. We're going to give you the 25 points, that's what she told us. His favorite fattening food, and she said blackout cake. Morty Gunty.
Yes. Well, we live in a neighborhood where there's a bakery, and they have this kind of cake that's called blackout cake. It was, I don't know why they call it that, but it's a lot of chocolate and chocolate cake with chocolate in the middle, with chocolate icing, with chocolate around it. It's all chocolate.
That's what she told us, and we're going to give you 25 chocolate points. Very good, Marty. Okay. Now it's time to get our final scores, meet our big winners, but first this message.
Up next, love is on the air as star couples become star-crossed lovers. More He Said, She Said is coming up on Buzzer, where love plays.
Our couples are all together. Johnny, who's the winning couple?
Joe, with 165 points. The winners are the Gunties.
Okay, again the Gunties. All right. You've got a card in front of you, Marty. Would you read the name on the card?
Yes. The winners are Mr. and Mrs. Herbert Wetter of Millburn, New Jersey.
There they are.
Way up in the corner, and congratulations to you nice folks. You've won an exciting week for two at a glamorous holiday inn of your choice in the USA or anywhere in the world, such as Greensboro, North Carolina. Get the Holiday Inn habit and go.
Well, congratulations to our winners and to our panel. Jack, I have your book in front of me, Shut Up and Eat Your Snowshoes. Where did you come up with that title?
Well, it's all about the Canadian, northern Canada where we live.
Yeah, but yeah. Eat Your Snowshoes.
Well, it's just a comedy title, Joe.
Comedy title. Yeah. I figured that would come from you. Rachel, maybe you gave it to him, huh, that title?
Oh, no, I don't.
Oh, no, you don't?
No.
Okay. Yeah. Well, we're glad you came here and told us about that spaghetti fattening everybody up there. Marty, we're glad to find out that you like blackout cake and play tennis. Mickey, you got a new book coming out. I haven't heard about it.
Oh, Tough Guys come out about a week and a half ago.
I'm a big Spillane man.
The
last
movie's coming out.
Delta Factor. That was, you're in the movie, right, Sherry?
Right.
Tough Guys, I'll get in that movie.
Okay.
Alejandro, take care of that little housewife who works so hard for
she's
you.
She's so good.
She's always cleaning
she
house.
She buys the ice cream for
going
me.
Going out to buy ice cream. How much ice cream do you eat? You don't eat pounds of it with that
figure. I can't eat a pound.
Really?
Without blinking an eye.
Would you believe he's taught our dog to eat ice cream?
Your dog?
He sits up and barks for the ice cream. Yeah. So I have to feed
both of them. He goes out every afternoon and buys an ice cream cone.
Oh, come on. Well, that's our panel. The name of the show is He Said, She Said. My name is Joe Garagiola. Bye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for He Said, She Said, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.